Hey, so this is hour 17. Just me and Rob training today. We are working on the butterfly guard, so stretching the person out there, or stretching out my legs, sorry, to push them back, lifting up on their elbows as well. And the good thing about being so few on numbers is you can drill and drill and drill and drill and drill. I'm just, maybe there's less distractions, but I feel like I get to drill more often, repeat the drills when it's just, when there's less people around. And so here's Justin then, as usual, taking us through some of the key parts. I think we're about to move on from just getting that person off you to actually flipping them over and taking the top position. There's quite a lot to think about here. I would want to fight for double overhooks and make sure that my head is on the right side. Keep it nice and tight, and then I want to sort of toss him over. That was absolutely terrible. When he's going over, I want to be stuck to him like glue, so I take the top. It's not really a case of getting him off me, it's really a case of getting on top, getting in that top position. So, oh no, overhook, yeah, double underhook, sorry, and then rolling over. So I think the problem I'm having here actually is that I'm falling backwards and then rolling over to the side, when really what I want to do is just roll to the side, as you saw a minute ago, Justin sort of twisting his arms, and that's really the motion we want, rather than falling back and rolling. If you look at the gaps in the gas, so when I'm drilling with Rob is really difficult, because there's so many gaps, because he's so much longer than me. So it's difficult for me to close down those gaps. Whereas you might have just noticed a second ago when he was practicing on me, there's almost no gaps, because I'm so small and I almost fit into them. Yeah, so that can be frustrating, you know. If you post both his arms on the floor, you'll see in a minute. It's like a jungle gym. So Justin, again, just going through some pointers about how we want to be pulling on those elbows whilst sitting up. So sitting up, getting the double underhooks, getting the butterflies correct, getting the rollover, and keeping tight that time. High double underhook, so right up under his armpit. Need to keep those hooks and the butterfly hooks being tight on his legs. See, they're loose. You can see my feet almost running up and down his legs. They're not even connected. One of them needs to come off, the other one should be connected and pushing him over. So from there, Justin modeled to us on me, kicking out the ankle. But if you, as you can see, I can't reach that. I can't reach the ankle. Certainly not enough to give it a kick. So a slight adjustment there from Justin, just to go for the knee instead and roll over that way. But here's what I was talking about. See, where the hands are on the mat now from Rob, which you wouldn't want to do in jiu-jitsu anyway. So, but because of that, it's pretty much like climbing a climbing frame. See how much space there is in between us, where I have to keep my butt on the floor and keep the underhooks high. And see here the difference? Almost no space between them. He's barely even had to extend his legs to make that gap. And of course he can kick the ankle away and toss over. So if you can't make the kick, well, they're defending against it well. Go for the arm, take the hook, and roll over that way. And look again, you know, I have to really consider how I'm going to close that gap. I need to get a bit closer, so maybe a high underhook there, so I can reach across. But I mean, that's a distance. Probably fit three of me under Rob with him on his feet and his hands like that. Yeah, it makes it difficult and a little bit frustrating. again there, I sort of fell backwards and then rolled him over, when really, as you saw Justin do there, it's more like a sort of rotation, more like a windmill effect. Grab the arm. Try not to go backwards. Okay, good. Or better. And you'll see here, look, that's what I'm doing, going backwards and rolling over, and that's what I really want to do. See, you unhook one of the butterfly hooks and then use that to twist you over. So drill it again. A little bit better. So roll number one of two, I think. So it's just me and Rob, so we just did some 3 or 4 minute rounds. Maybe 4 minute rounds we often do. And again, I'm starting in the seated position. Trying to get that lock on the leg. All of this is a bit of a waste of time, really. We should just start in a position. There we go, so he sort of pulls me into that one, really. I want to get my knee up over his knee, secure that half guard, get that lock on. So he's going to be wanting to fight that now and escape that knee, escape that leg. And I'm going to want to escape from underneath him. Doing a really good job of trying to keep his posture down, but he breaks up. Once he's up, he can push away my knee and escape. There it is. So my main priority now then is to just keep trying to get back into it. Try and get my knee underneath his body and then get a half guard in again. I think I got it here. Yeah. Get an underhook to keep his posture down. And he escapes that, first of all. And then he is gonna escape that half guard. And you can see his hands there trying to meet together, go for a guillotine. So I didn't really have much of a choice but to stand up and try and stack him into it, try and escape out. Good grip on the back of my head, but just managed to pop it out there at the end. I'm now in his half guard, so I'm gonna escape that. Get caught on the exit, but managed to escape my knee out. Now what I really should be doing is coming all the way around to the side of him. But instead, I try to jump over, I jump over the top, which gives up the control I had on that side. Now I've got to fight his knees again. He's got a knee shield in across my belly. I try and pull that out. He slips the other leg in and I'm into his guard. Posture up and escape that. His guard's open, so I'll just stand up and escape, and then we'll start again. So I'm standing this time, never really start in this position. I managed to roll him over, but then he was just so baffled by the idea I'd done it that he sort of bounces back, and I end up putting him back in my half guard, just locking the leg up. It's a bit of a shame, really, that most of our rolling consists of me trying to trap his leg and him trying to escape my leg. But yeah, he's twice the size of me, so I can't really do too much else other than just survive last the time. Okay. End of round two. One, start of roll two then. A little bit more aggressive on the start for this one for Rob. Go straight in for the Achilles lock. I feel pretty confident in escaping this one. He gets a body triangle across my body, so that prevents me from being able to sit up. I still got my left leg quite high up, so he's not able to apply the heel hook just yet, as if I was flattened out. I know I've got to fight these feet. I really want to fight his hands. Justin reminds me in a second that I need to break that triangle across my body before I can escape any other way. So yeah, try and push. Yeah, good idea there to get off my hand. It's just sitting there doing nothing on the ground. I need to use both hands on both feet to escape and roll over. He breaks. I want to make sure that it doesn't cross him again, but it does. Rolling to and fro and to and fro, and then eventually I managed to break that open, escape. I want to turn around and face him if I can, but fall straight into his guard. So from guard then, I'm just trying to posture up, trying to break the guard using my knee in the back of his top bottom of his spine, I suppose. Goes for a triangle attempt there. I'm trying to control the heel so I can kick it to the side, take side control, and then we just scoop back into the middle. So again, he's got the Achilles hook on, but I managed to keep my foot at a bit of a right angle, full back, and then use my other foot to escape. Use my other foot to escape one foot while I kick him in the face, and he lets go. And we just wind up right over against the wall here. He's got a really good side control. Looks like he's trying to go for, I don't know, the mount there. We're quite close to the wall though. We probably should have restarted here. And then a final roll for the night. I'm absolutely wiped. It's bad enough I've got to climb all over him like a jungle gym, just in the drills, and then afterwards I have to put up with all of his weight crushing down on me. So I think he's tried this a couple of weeks ago, the side control and trapping the arm. I managed to get out. And I wouldn't mind taking him into the guard, but does a good job of preventing that. Over the top for a guillotine. Both hands fighting his hands there, so I'm just trying to break that hand around from the back of my head. I want to get my hand over the back of his head, see, like that. So then I can take head and arm control, then I can start to posture up and escape my knee. And as soon as I'm about to do my first little bump to escape, that knee rolls me straight over. I've got one foot trapped underneath, so I can't quite make half guard. He's got one leg down, passes my guard into half. I could probably do a couple of submissions here with my arm there as it is. I don't know what they are. Daniel Roper Jones does them to me quite a lot. And so then, yeah, the inevitable happens. Get into mount. With each bump that I'm doing to bridge him away, just getting worse and worse after that. I just don't keep my butt off the ground at the time. Four in a row, and then you're spent. You can't bump anymore. You've just got this weight on top of you. There he comes around. Oops. Probably gonna consider that armbar. There it is. I need to defend that. Roll over. Really, all I'm doing here is just keeping my thumb away from him, having it straight up. If my thumb's pointing to the mat as it is now, then he could put the armbar on. If I've got it facing to the left or the right, then I won't submit. So here he goes, and this is the mount take. From the mount take, takes the arm. My elbow's just below his hips there, but a bit of force, and yeah, that submission. Now I had Rob on his feet a few times, on his back a few times on this, and I had control over his ankles, and Justin's just gonna go through with us very quickly how we can defend that. Oop. Pretty easy. Just a couple of things then to look for next time. I need to work on keeping my hook tight. High and tight. It's my target from last week, but it'll just keep rolling over until I get it. And my overhooks, my underhooks, those butterfly hooks, they all need to be tight to wherever they should be, whether they're high up on the arm or whether the hooks are deep and high up in the legs. I need to work on that. Secondly, I need to work on closing the gap between mine and my opponent's body. So whether that means I need to work on my own core strength to keep my body closer to them, or my body strength to close down that gap in some way, I still need to make sure that those gaps are closed. And that's about it. Next week is hour 18. I can't believe how quickly I'm getting through all these hours of training. So as hour 24 looms, I might even do a roundup of my first 24 hours of training. We'll see how it goes. For now though, it's week 18 next week. See you then.